So today we shall study the examples on the formula theta equal to L by R or L is equal to R theta or R is equal to L by theta. So the first example, find the radius of circle. Find the radius of circle in which central angle of 60 degree subtended at the center by an arc of length 22 centimeter. So use pi equal to 22/7. Use pi equal to 22/7. So the solution is, so here required radius of circle, that is R. Given that central angle, that is 60 degree, theta, we take 60 degree. And arc of length is denoted by L. L is equal to 22 centimeter. And given pi is 22/7. So use the formula, that is, we want R, so R equal to L by theta. Use formula R equal to L by theta. So this is used, this formula used when L and R have same unit. L and R have same units. And theta is in radian. So here given that theta is in degree. So convert this into radian. That is 60 into pi by 180 radian. 60 into pi by 180 radian. So it is 1s are 3s are. It is pi by 3 radian. So theta is pi by 3. So now put here, L is given as 22 and theta is equal to pi by 3. So R is equal to, we calculate 22 by pi into this 3. This 3 become numerator. So 22 into 3 is 66. This 22 into 3 is 66. Pi value is 22/7. So this we can write 66 into 7. This become numerator divided by 22. So 22 ones are 22 threes are. So 3 into 7 is 21. So what is R is equal to 21 centimeter. So L is given in centimeter. So R also in centimeter. That is 21 centimeter. This is example on radius. Next, second example. Next, second example is find the angle at the center. At the center in radian described by arc of length 44 centimeter, radius of circle is 20 centimeter. That is, we want the angle at the center in radian, that is theta required. Given that arc length denoted by symbol L, 44 centimeter. Radius is given by R. R is equal to 20 centimeter. So we want theta. So theta is equal to simple L by R. So L is 44. R is 20. So that is 4 11s are 4 5s are, so 11 by 5. 11 by 5 is 2.5. Okay. 25 on the 5 2s are 10, so one carry 10, 2.2. So 2.2 radian. 2.2 radian. So it is also can be written as 2 degree plus 0, 2, oh sorry. This is the 2.2 radian only, because L and R have same unit, this centimeter, they get cancelled. So if unit is not mentioned, that is mean that the angle in radian. So the theta is 2.2 radian. Similarly, third example. length of minor arc described by the circle, described by minor arc of the circle, comma, whose radius is 20 centimeter and length of chord is 20 centimeter. This is important example. So we want the length, minor arc of the circle. Whose radius is given as, that is 20 centimeter. Now we have to take the chord. The chord of length also 20 centimeter. So I take here. This is the length of the chord is 20 centimeter. So now this is the minor arc. This one is minor arc, and this is the major arc. So this is the minor arc. So we want the minor arc of the circle. Length of minor arc. This 20 centimeter, and length of chord is 20 centimeter, and this is the radius, that is 20 centimeter. So it becomes the equilateral triangle. So angle at the center is 60 degree. Equilateral triangle. So each angle is same, that is each equal to 60 degree. So now, so given that here theta is equal to 60 degree, angle at the center is theta 60 degree, and the radius of the circle is given as 20 centimeter. So now we find the length of arc L equation of. So we know the formula L is equal to theta, but theta must be in radians. So therefore we convert this 60 into pi by 180, 61 the 63 the, so it is pi by 3 radian. So L is equal to R is 20 into theta pi by 3. So it is 20 pi by 3. 20 into pi by 3. So we can put the value of pi also. 20 by 3 into pi is 22 by 7. That is 3. It is nearly 20.95 centimeter. So in a circle of diameter 50 centimeter, the length of chord is 25 centimeter. Find the length of minor arc. Find the length of minor arc by the chord. So you have same. So you given that diameter is given. This is the diameter. How much given? It is 50 centimeter. So the radius is always half of diameter, d by 2. So 50 divided by 2 is 25 centimeter. This is the radius. 25 centimeter. Now length of cord is given 25 centimeter. Length of cord. So cord, I will take this cord. This is given cord is 25 centimeter. So this will again radius. This is also 25 centimeter. So given now it is equilateral triangle. So angle at the center of circle is pi by 3. That is 60 degree. 60 degree is equal to pi by 3 radian. 60 degree is nothing but pi by 3 radian. So this is pi by 3 radian. So this is the minor arc described by the chord. This is the major arc. So your asked question is to find the length of minor arc. So minor arc is given by, now it is length of arc L is equal to r theta. R is 25 and theta is pi by 3. So 25 into pi by 3. We can keep this much, no problem. Otherwise you can put, take pi equal to 22/7. 25 into 25 by 3 and pi value is 22/7. So this is the length of arc. So it is 26.1 centimeter. Find the length of minor arc. So put the first question, what is the length of major arc? This one. So now what is the length of major arc of the circle? This we want. So now angle subtended by this arc is this much. So angle subtended by this arc at the center is this one. And this is complete rotation is 360 and it is means minus 60. This is what, minus 60, then 300 it is. So angle at the center by the major arc is 300 degree. Angle at center by the major arc is 300 degrees. So it is in radian, 300 into pi by 180. It cancels. So that is, so that 3 tens are 3 sixes. Again 2 fives are 2 threes. So it is 5 pi by 3 radian. So now what is length of major arc? L is equal to r theta again. So r is equal to 25 and theta is 5 pi by 3. So it is 25 into 5, 125 divided by 3 into 22/7 pi value. So 25 into 5, 125 divided by 3 into 22/7. centimeter. So like this you can find the length of major arc and length of minor arc. If in two circles, angle at the centers are 60 degree and 75 degree respectively, having same arc length, find the ratio of their radii. So here two circles, so take this circle radius r1 and this r1, and let angle at the center is theta 1. This is the length of arc L1. And for second circle, the radius is r2. Angle at the center is theta 2 and length of arc is L2. So length of arc of the circle is given by L equal to r theta. So for the first circle, L1 equal to r1 theta 1. And for the second circle, that is L2 is equal to r2 into theta 2. So here given that length of, having same arc length, given that length of arc is same, so L1 is equal to L2. This is given. Length of arc is same length of arc, so L1 is equal to L2. So L1 is nothing but R1 theta 1 and L2 is R2 theta 2. Here asked to find the ratio of the radii, means R1, ratio of radii is R1 divided by R2 is equal to theta 2 divided by theta 1. ratio of the radii r1, this r2 take to the LHS denominator, theta 2 and this become denominator. So now given is angle at the centers given. So first circle theta 1 is 60 degree and for second circle theta 2 is 75 degree. So this is 60 degree is nothing but we have to convert into radian, 60 into pi by 180. So this is pi by 3 radian. And 75 degree again have to convert into radian, 75 into pi by 180. So this is 545 is a 525 is a. Again we can convert 536 is this. So we can 54 the 55 4 the then 55 the it is 3 into 25 into 3 180 by 25 the carries 55 the 15 then this is 54 the 5 3 the 15 3 carries 6, 36, then 3, 5 the, 3, 12 the, so it is 5 pi by 12. So now we keep here r1 divided by r2 is equal to, theta 2 is 5 pi by 12, divided by theta 1 is pi by 3. So this r1 divided by r2, you know how to solve this, 5 pi by 12, and this denominator conjugate should multiply, denominator reciprocal should multiply. 5 by 12 divided by 3 by pi. So 3 on the 3, 4 the pi will cancel. So it is 5 is 5 by 4. So r1 divided by r2 is equal to 5 by 4. And ratio is r1 is to r2 is equal to 5 is to 4. This is a very important example. So r1 is to r2 is equal to 5 is to 4. That is required ratio. So we can directly also solve here 75, here 60. 75 divided by 60. The simple theta 2 by theta 1 75 divided by 60 15 4 the 15 5 the that is 5 by 4. So here only can write 5 is to 4. So but in theory exams you have to do detail. That is first length of arc is first circle r1 l1 equal to r1 theta 1 and for second circle l2 equal to r2 theta 2. So here given that l1 is equal to l2, so we write r1 by r2 equal to theta 2 by theta 1. This is very important. R1 by R2 is equal to theta 2 by theta 1. So theta 2 is given as 5 by 12. So this, when you using this formula, you have to convert into radians. That is 5 by 12. And theta 1 is 5 pi by 3. So we can solve. So we get R1 is to R2 equal to 5 is to 4. So remaining examples will continue tomorrow in the next class.